Hello, this is Cristi. In this video, I will show you how you can quickly create social media clips with Camtasia. And this is facilitated by a new feature that was added in the 2024 version, and that is dynamic captions. You may have seen those online everywhere, and there's lots of tools out there that do it, automatically adding the captions on the video. But Camtasia now allows you to do that too. And it does it quite well. And actually, it has some features that others don't. So let's dive in and have a look at this. So I have a blank project in here. I don't have any media added to it. And I will bring a clip from one of my podcast episodes that I recorded with my friend Chris Menard. So I'm going to just drag that video into my media bin there. And now I'm going to right-click and add it to my timeline. At the beginning, there it is. So there's my clip. It has audio. It's quite short, less than 30 seconds, and it has no captions on it at all.
I do about 120 to 150 videos a year, public videos.
So now, how do I create a social media clip out of this? The length is nice. If you bring clips from a different source, or you record them right in here, or you record them with Riverside or something else, you have to bring those videos in and cut them up and edit them. I'm not going to cover that in this video because I've already selected a portion of my video to use as a clip. So let's suppose that I want to create this social media clip as a vertical one. First thing I need to do is to turn my canvas, my entire project really, in Camtasia into a vertical canvas. So if I take this away for a second, I'll just delete it. You see the canvas is now landscape and it does match my recording, but I want a vertical clip. So I have to go and change the aspect ratio of my entire project. So I'm going to go to the top where the zoom level is, and I'm going to go to project settings. And in here, you've got whatever the default is, full HD or whatever the video that you had was. And I'm going to change this to one of the options in here. At the bottom in Camtasia, you have 916 full HD, which is exactly the same, the full HD one, but it's turned sideways. So you've got 1080 by 1920. This is the recommended size for social media clips. I'm going to select this one and click apply. And if I zoom out now, look, my canvas is now vertical. So now I'm going to bring my video in. I'm going to drag it, put it on the canvas here. Camtasia will scale it automatically to match to fit in the middle there. But what I want to do is I want to make this very tall. So I'm going to move it at the top and pull the bottom to scale it up. And you can see that actually the video kind of goes outside of the screen. So I may have to move it in like this. And also you can crop it. So if you don't like the fact that it's going outside of the sides of your screen, that's not a problem. Those areas are not going to be visible when you export anyway. But if it bothers you, you can go into crop mode at the top, or you can press the Alt key or Option on the Mac, and then you see that the video area turns into a blue, it has a blue outline, and these handles allow me to drag and crop the video to fit inside of that screen area. There you go. That's my vertical clip. Now, of course, if your guest moves left or right, you may have to adjust this with animation and keep him in sync in the middle of your canvas, because Camtasia doesn't automatically do that yet. So let's play this now.
I do about 120 to 150 videos a year.
So great. He doesn't move a lot. The video is great. Let's now put the animated captions on. So as I was saying at the beginning, this was not possible in Camtasia until version 2024, which includes now dynamic captions. And another thing it includes is the ability to automatically transcribe the audio, because you can't have dynamic captions if you don't have the transcript of the audio. I haven't actually imported a transcription for this file. You will see how Camtasia automatically does that in the background. So let's go to captions. And I am on a Mac here, and I see the captions here, dynamic caption styles. On Windows, you may actually see two tabs in here, but you need to switch to the dynamic captions because the caption section is organized differently on the Mac than Windows. So you can see here, Camtasia comes with a bunch of styles pre-built. And I want you to watch carefully what happens down here in the timeline when I drag one of these styles at the bottom there on the timeline. So I need to grab these captions, one of these styles. Doesn't matter which ones, you can define your own. but I'm going to just use this one for example, and I'm going to bring it down here and watch now on the timeline what happens to my clip. You see that little progress for a second there? That is when Camtasia actually transcribed the audio. And look at this. On my canvas now, I have this little annotation clip, if you want, which has the captions and the current word is actually highlighted. So let's see how it works.
Public videos. And sometimes I like, this video is going to knock.
There you go. This is great. And you can adjust the size of this if you want it to be sort of not so wide. And if you don't like it, that it has just one line of text, that's not a problem. If you resize it to make room for more text, you see more text. You can actually go quite high and just show as much text as you like. That's quite nice. You can place it and you can animate this, by the way, because it just behaves like a normal clip on your timeline. You can animate this and have it bounce or move around. Doesn't matter. Let me show you how you can customize this. If you go to the right-hand side, you have these text options in the A section. At the top, you basically have the settings for a regular text box, which allow you to change the font, the style, the size of the text, the stroke, all those things. But if you scroll down, you now have a section called Dynamic Caption. And this has much more options than other tools I've seen. Even Descript has this feature and has had it for a long time, but it doesn't do all of the options that you have here. So plenty of customization options. Now, before we customize that, if you see on the timeline, this caption clip that I added is actually much longer than my actual video clip or audio. So I will just make it shorter like this. It just comes with a predefined length. And now that I've done that, I'm going to go and customize this. So here are some options that you can use to customize. You can change the highlighting. So the highlighting is this blue thing that highlights the current word being spoken. As you listen to the words being spoken, you can see them being highlighted with that default kind of blue color. That is not a problem. You can change the color, by the way, right there. I'm going to use orange if I want to. And there you go. If I play this,
get out of the park.
Then you can change you can turn off the highlighting, by the way, if you don't want it. And if you can change the fill of the word color, the default word color. Let's assume that I want my words to actually be orange themselves. And I'm going to change the background to maybe green or white or black. You know, it's your choice. Then you've got the word opacity. So the options, I recommend that you customize these from top to bottom. First of all, change your default main word color. Then you can change the stroke color. If you want to have a stroke around your words, it is black by default, but if I make it white, you can see what it does. It just adds an outline for the words. And also, you can change the word opacity. So here you have two words. You have the future words and you have the past words. Past words are words you've already said, and the future words are words that haven't been said yet. So if I move my playhead so that the highlighted word is somewhere in the middle, any word that's been before the highlighted word has already been spoken. So if I take the past word and make it less opaque like this, look, it disappears or it becomes more faded. If I pull this other slider, I can control the future words and I can make those faded too. And you can go as, you know, just at the very bottom, you can see zero and zero. So right now, I only see the word that I'm currently speaking, right?
Video. And no one cares about it.
Very nice. Now, let me just put those back in there. And now, I can also customize the word background. So that is the word, the current word background, right? It is black at the moment. I can make it blue, black again. You have a scale here. You can scale that background. And you can change the radius to make it rounded corners. And you can change the time. The timing means how long does it take for that word to animate from the current word to the next. So the shorter it is, the word jumps faster. So here we go.
And then I'll make a video. And
you see the word highlight just jumps automatically. But if I make the time longer, you will see that word highlight slide between the words.
I'm like, this video is just dumb. I'm making it.
So it has an animation between the words. That's, again, your choice how to do it. You can also have the easing of that and the scaling. So you can actually scale the current word. And I've seen this effect in a lot of the programs out there where the current word just pops up off the screen. That is exactly what this does.
One of my subscribers asked me to.
And again, that is controlled with the easing. And you can have sort of the main word, the words being spoken, zoomed in the most, but then the adjacent words zoomed in less and so on. So they create a bit of like a kind of a wave effect here.
Some friend, I heard someone saying they didn't know how to do this.
So plenty, plenty of options to customize the words. And finally, you have the block. You can change the background of the entire block. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to just make that white and turn the opacity up. So look at this. You are actually putting the whole block of text on its own separate background that is different from the highlighted word. So I'm going to make that one black. And you can change the opacity so it's kind of see-through. One thing that I like here, which I haven't seen in other applications, is being able to have a transition between the current block of text and the next block of text. So when we arrive at the end of the words here, the block changes with the next words, and that is when you can add a transition here. So you basically have access to the list of the all of the transitions included with Camtasia. There's more than 100 now, I think 150 or something like that. And you can choose whatever you want. Like, let's choose blinds. So if I scroll like this, you can see the transition happening when the words change, when the blocks change. So watch this.
I do about 120 to 150 videos a year, public videos. And sometimes I like this video.
So there you go. And again, you can control the length of that transition to make it shorter or longer. So it takes me a long time just to go through all of the customization options there, plenty to choose from. And two more things I want to say. If you find a style that you like and you don't want to have to create it again next time, you can go to the top here and choose this plus icon, which in Camtasia allows you to save a preset. So I'm going to say social media clips 2. Okay, click OK. And now that preset you just created shows up in the list of presets that you have there to apply them next time. One more question that you may have is, what if I want to make corrections to the text? Maybe I don't want this word here, gonna. Well, this is how you correct the words that have been transcribed, because I'm pretty sure an AI system like this is not going to get all the words properly. So, for that reason, you may want to have changes to some words. So the way to do that, you see this block here where it says you want to select the audio because the transcription stays with the audio. So if I click on the audio in the timeline, there are the words. And you can move left or right and you can see the current word being highlighted in there too. Let's say I want to double click to correct this word gonna. Double click and type going to. And you see, as I'm typing it, it gets corrected on the screen and in the transcript. If I use this clip somewhere else in my project somewhere else, that transcription is going to be corrected because I corrected it in one place. There you go.
Gonna knock it out of the park.
So there's your social media clips in here. All you have to do now is just go to export as a local file, save it as a video, upload it to YouTube or wherever, and you're done. I really like this because you can save these presets, you can reuse them, and you're up and running in no time. What do you think of this feature? Let me know in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more videos where I will show you all of the other features that were added in Camtasia 2024. See you next time.